Although most professional wrestlers are solid citizens, in the hands of their publicity men, they become the most colorful group of characters in the world and possibly the universe. For example, a frustrated ballet dancer takes on a refugee from the animal world. That's the only way to describe a meeting of the gay, light-footed Ricky Starr and the Zebra Kid. Ricky's wearing a pair of crazy pink shoes, and watch those twinkling toes and the hula hips. Ricky, a drawing card second only to Argentina Rocca, spies an especially ardent admirer, and he tiptoes out of the ring to present personally one of the slippers that gave him a bad case of sore feet in his last engagement. He asked to be excused by his worthy adversary, but after all, what could a zebra say anyway? The show is underway. The stars are out tonight. Ricky twinkles around his dazzled opponent with all the innocence and soft qualities of a wounded bluebird in nervous flight. Star ends his number with a light leap and a coquettish pose at a safe distance from the kid, only to sneak up slyly on his unwary rival. Ricky manfully fights his way free from the clutches of the masked one and then swishes his hips in a manner that would make the queen of the hop green with envy. Zebra Kid is having little luck with the sylph-like Ricky. Star leaps over the kid as if he were just an oversized fire hydrant and pitches him a knuckleball. Star pounds the kid with a furious barrage of passionate slaps. Star goes into a joyous war dance before finally putting his straight man on the mat for good. Ricky goes into a crazy tailspin as he stays on for an encore after the match is over. It's a good night for Ricky Star and cast as they successfully stage another bloody battle in the savage circle of thwarted thespians.